Right now, three major health threats are unfolding. From a mysterious giant virus in Finland to a deadly outbreak in Colombia and historic global action against future pandemics, this is Health Bulletin, and here's what you need to know. Are you aware that some viruses can be significantly larger than those causing the flu or coronavirus? Introducing the giant viruses, a unique category of microscopic giants that are altering our understanding of viruses. Recently, researchers in Finland encountered their first giant virus, dubbed Jyväskylä virus, named after the city of its discovery. This immense virus measures approximately 200 nanometers, which is about twice the size of the influenza or COVID-19 viruses. The discovery process is intriguing. Scientists combined environmental samples with amoebas to uncover this colossal virus hidden within soil. It belongs to a family of giant viruses, initially identified in France, indicating that these larger viruses may be more prevalent than previously believed, even in northern regions. Giant viruses possess large genomes, sometimes comprising millions of DNA base pairs, far exceeding those of regular viruses. Studying these viruses could reveal secrets about microscopic ecosystems and environmental dynamics, such as how certain Arctic viruses infect algae that contribute to ice melting. Finland's discovery is only the beginning. Researchers have already detected indications of additional giant viruses within their samples, paving the way for promising future studies. Next, Colombia is currently grappling with a severe yellow fever outbreak, leading the government to declare a national health and economic emergency. Since early 2025, there have been 74 confirmed cases and at least 34 fatalities, resulting in a nearly 50% mortality rate. The Tolima region is the outbreak's epicenter, witnessing a surge in cases from just 4 last September to 22 by mid-April. Most of the infections are associated with rural communities nearby the Bosque de Galilea Natural Park, where heavy rainfall provides perfect breeding conditions for mosquitoes. Yellow fever, a virus spread by mosquitoes, leads to symptoms such as fever, muscle pain, nausea, and headaches. In severe instances, it can cause jaundice and hemorrhage. While the virus is endemic in Colombia, the current outbreak is notable for its swift spread and high death toll. Authorities are intensifying vaccination initiatives and mandating proof of yellow fever vaccinations for individuals entering or leaving Colombia. The World Health Organization and CDC are recommending vaccinations for travelers, particularly those visiting high-risk areas below 7,150 feet in altitude. The message is straightforward. Vaccination is the most effective protection. If you're planning to travel to Colombia or reside in impacted regions, verify your vaccination status and implement mosquito bite prevention measures. Stay tuned for further developments regarding this unfolding public health situation. I mean, after over 3 years of rigorous negotiations, countries have achieved a significant milestone, a global treaty aimed at addressing future pandemics. In Geneva, World Health Organization member states finalized the draft for an international pandemic treaty designed to enhance global safety and preparedness for upcoming health crises. If approved at next month's World Health Assembly, this treaty will be legally binding for 194 nations.
We celebrate the successful conclusion of negotiations on a draft pandemic agreement, completed in just 3.5 years. And as Tlalani from Lesotho said, with many sleepless nights, a remarkable feat. As such, international agreements often take a decade or longer to finalize. This achievement is not just a diplomatic success. I think some of you have already said that. It reflects your resilience, unity, and unwavering commitment to the health and well-being of people everywhere. In the face of enormous challenges, you have come together, rising above borders and differences, united by a common goal, the protection of humanity. The proposed agreement is a significant step forward in improving our global response to future pandemic threats. By reaching this milestone together, you have made history and shown how powerful collaboration can be. This consensus is essential as it sets the stage for effective implementation and demonstrates that multilateralism is alive and well. And consensus also means it's now owned by all of you. And that's the start of an effective implementation. The importance of this agreement goes beyond our current challenges. It's vital for future generations, our children and grandchildren. By building a strong framework for pandemic preparedness and response, we ensure they inherit a safer and healthier world.
It aims to bolster pandemic prevention, preparedness, and response, emphasizing principles like the prompt sharing of information, pathogen samples, and genetic data. The agreement also highlights the One Health concept, acknowledging the interrelation of human, animal, and environmental health. For the first time ever, there will be a binding obligation for collaborative surveillance and fair access to vaccines, tests, and treatments. Manufacturers will need to adhere to the WHO framework, ensuring that at least 20% of pandemic-related products are accessible for global use, with half provided either for free or at a minimal cost. Nonetheless, not every nation is in agreement. The United States did not take part in the concluding negotiations and its plans to disengage from the WHO in 2026. Regardless, global health leaders regard the treaty as a gift to our children and grandchildren, representing a legacy of unity and preparedness following the COVID-19 experience. Discussions will persist to address remaining differences, yet the world is now one step closer to a more secure and united response to future pandemics. These updates prove global health is fragile. Stay informed, stay prepared, and subscribe Health Bulletin for more update on health and science.